It was 1998, and WCW was coming to the Lehigh Valley for one of its first stops, and Ric Flair flew into the ABE airport, which, Colt, I know you have flown into. It's a tiny little airport now in town. And he was looking to work out before his event, and he stopped at an LA Fitness, and he just tried to walk in and bypass the counter, and he was stopped, and they said, "Excuse me, sir, come back. You have to sign in." And he turned to my friend's mom and said, "I'm Ric Flair." And my friend's mom turned back and said, "Does Ric Flair have a membership?" So from now on, my friends and I have been asking each other if we have memberships. And it shows you what kind of star power some of the wrestlers thought they may have had in the 80s and 90s. But loving the confidential podcast, and I miss you from Allentown.
In the 80s and 90s, well, some of those wrestlers still have that attitude now. Of course, these calls are anonymous and confidential, but this caller in Allentown sure does remind me of my good friend Ian Riccaboni. Sounded a lot like him, too. Ian Riccaboni is the voice of Ring of Honor and also hosts a podcast with Kerry Silkin called Last Stop from Penn Station. Kerry Silkin, the former owner of Ring of Honor, has stories and stories and stories to tell, and he is telling them on the Last Stop from Penn Station podcast. Subscribe and listen where you listen to podcasts. I may or may not have told Kerry about this show, so feel free to badger him a little bit about sending in a story. Anonymously, of course. You know who's not anonymous? Ric Flair. He wants the world to know exactly who he is, and that is a situation that makes me happy. When someone who thinks they are a star of stars gets completely checked and brought back to earth a little bit. And you know I'm more than happy when Ric Flair gets put in check a little bit. Does Ric Flair have a membership? I wonder if Ric Flair has the $30,000 that he owes Kerry Silkin. Wow, this all came full circle, didn't it? Well, anonymous caller from Allentown, I love those kind of stories that will always become an inside joke for the rest of your life that you and your friends can tell. And I'm glad that it's at the expense of the Nature Boy. Hey, thanks for watching. That call was part of a whole podcast called Wrestling Anonymous. Listen to the whole thing weekly. Wherever you listen to your podcast, go subscribe. While you're at it, subscribe right here on YouTube to Colt Cabana's channel. Thank you.